In conclusion, I come back to my slide on the seemingly conflicting goals when creating robot apps. On one hand, we want to be robust against variations and deal with human interaction, requiring complex sensor-based control, and on the other hand, we need a decreased development cost of these applications due to the small production series. The resolution of these seemingly conflicting goals lies, I think, in a better definition of the different stakeholder roles that are involved in the software development for robot applications. We attempt to achieve these goals by splitting up the development of our robot applications into three roles: a system developer, an application developer, and a robot installer slash operator. On one end, we have the system developer. The system developer is involved in the specific control aspect and control architecture, and he develops a way to specify the real application. He designs a language to describe learnable skills. In our case, this language is ETASL. The main motivation of this system developer is to make the job of the application developer easier. This is a major effort requiring a lot of time to develop, but this effort is largely independent of the specific type of application, so we can write this method off over a large number of applications. The second role is the application developer. It's the job of the application developer to quickly develop a more or less generic robot application that can be easily deployed in many different sites. He wants to develop a robot app. The methods that I discussed previously provide the tool to do this. We have a modeler task specification language that can describe the different aspects of a robot application related to the task at hand, to the robot, to the workpiece, and to the environment. And we also have a way to adapt the application to the needs of a specific deployment by using our programming by demonstration techniques. Together, this combination of constraint-based specifications and specifications of aspects that need to be demonstrated form a specification of the robot application in terms of learnable skills. One of the goals of these application developers is to make the job of the robot installer and slash operator as easy as possible by providing good programming by demonstration primitives. Using these learnable skills, the application developer designs a more generic robot application that can be written off over many different deployments at different sites. The robot installer slash operator then uses this generic application to deploy it at a specific site in a very concrete setting. The installer and the day-to-day operator can be a different person. But in fact, it should be our ambition to make the process as simple enough such that this can be the same person. In this way, a robot application can be easily adapted to the day-to-day variations in the operation of a factory, and we really get robot apps.